This is the BBC.
This podcast is supported by advertising outside the UK.
Tired of ads crashing your comedy podcast party? Good news. Ad-free listening on Amazon Music is included with your Prime membership. Just head to amazon.com/adfreecomedy to catch up on the latest episodes without the ads.
Enjoy thousands of Acast shows ad-free for Prime subscribers. Some shows may have ads.
Hey, I'm Ryan Reynolds.
Recently, I asked Mint Mobile's legal team if big wireless companies are allowed to raise prices due to inflation. They said yes. And then when I asked if raising prices technically violates those onerous two-year contracts, they said, what the f*** are you talking about, you insane Hollywood ass f-.
So to recap, we're cutting the price of Mint Unlimited from $30 a month to just $15 a month. Give it a try at mintmobile.com/switch.
$45 up front for 3 months plus taxes and fees. Promo rate for new customers for limited time. Unlimited more than 40 gigabytes per month. Slows full terms at mintmobile.com.
BBC Sounds. Music, radio, podcasts.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to Tuesday's 10 to the Top. Hope you're all right. Thanks for listening. Whatever you're doing, whether you're on the tools, whether you're hauling, whether you're doing something productive, thank you very much for taking time out and tuning in. Basically, people use 10 to the Top as their 11s. It's a little bit early, but that's all right. We'll take it. Enjoy the quiz, and if you do well, then come and play. And if you don't do well, come and play, because when you do come and play, I promise you, when you're on air doing it live, you'll do better than you do if you are sat at home, at work, travelling on the train, wherever, listening to this. So come and play. 10totheTop@bbc.co.uk is the email.
BBC Radio 2, 10 to the Top.
Second day of the week, so let's welcome Ben Thomas in Telford. Hiya, Ben.
Hiya, Ben.
How is Telford? Is it all right?
Wet and miserable, but it's all right, yeah.
To be honest with you, Ben, I think that's the majority of this great nation at the moment. Wet, miserable and very, very cold.
Indeed, indeed.
However, you're used to that because you're an avid cold water swimmer. What got you into that?
It's something I started during the COVID lockdown, really. Always been a keen swimmer. And was just looking for something to sort of help with my mental health. And that got me into cold water swimming. And I've been doing it ever since.
Do you feel the benefits of cold water swimming? Because remember, there was that show on the BBC with Wim Hof. And he's adamant that dipping yourself in cold water for a certain period of time is good for your circulation. It's good for your blood flow. It's good for your mind. Have you felt the benefit?
Yeah, he's absolutely spot on with that, to be honest. It really does benefit you. I mean, you don't focus on anything else because it's so cold.
And you're a massive football fan as well. You follow Telford United. I like that. You follow the local team.
Yeah, follow the local team. They're actually doing okay. They've had a couple of bad seasons, but they're in for the promotion picture this year. And then I'm follow me, the England national team as well. So I've been down to Wembley a few times and hoping to go out to Germany in the summer for the Euros.
All right, good stuff. Hey, Ben, you're an ambulance technician. So on behalf of the nation, thank you.
Oh, thank you very much, yeah.
How long have you been doing that?
I've been doing that nearly 3 years now, yeah. So I was an accountant for sort of 10, 12 years of my life. Wasn't enjoying that. Wanted a bit of a career change and, 3 years in the ambulance service now.
Yeah, good for you. All right, so let's do 10 to the Top. How do you usually get on?
Depends what the questions are like. So if I can get double figures, I'll be really happy. To be honest today, if I can just score, I'll be happy.
Well, let me give you a reminder. This week on Radio 2, we're having a celebration of music and memories from years ending in 4, which means that all these questions are related to either 64, 74, 84, 94, 2004 or 2014. So, are you ready for your first question?
Let's go.
To the Top on Radio 2.
Who sang about a smooth operator back in September 1984?
I believe that was Sade.
It was Sade, yes. Well done. Up and running for 2 points. Here's a clip from the first of this following group's 4 chart entries during 1994. But who are they?
That's sounds like the beautiful south to me.
It is the beautiful south. Yes, perfect. Beautiful lyricist, Paul Heaton. Yeah, bravo. Well done.
Can I play my joker on the next question?
Ooh, Ben, we're going in with the joker on the 3-point question, yes? That means it's worth 6. Complete the title of this 1984 hit by the Smiths. William, it was what?
Nothing.
So close, yet so far away. It was William, it was really nothing.
Oh, no.
It was a half-decent guess, and that's a little bit disappointing because that was your joker question, which means it was worth 6 points.
Ah.
So we stumbled down the ladder. We can still put a good score together because this is only your 4th question and it's worth 1 point. So good luck. The 1994 comic relief single saw the Pet Shop Boys team up with the cast of which famous TV sitcom?
Royal Family.
It's a good guess, but it was absolutely fabulous.
Okay.
For a point, name the group who sang about The House of the Rising Sun on their number one in July 1964.
Was it The Animals?
We have a point. This one's worth 2. In what year did Jason Orange announce he'd officially left Take That? Remember, the year ends in 4.
2014.
Good answer. That gets you 2 points. We're on a roll now. This one's going to get you 3 if you get it correct. In the summer of 1994, the song Searching was a massive hit for the group China What?
Don't know that one, Vin. No.
Oh, it's China Black.
Unlucky.
This one's worth a point. In 1974, the biggest selling single was by Terry Jacks, and it was later covered by Westlife in the 90s. What is the 4-word song title?
Seasons in the Sun.
Yes. Gets you a point. Perfect. This is your last clip. It's worth 2 points. The actor Nigel Planer spent 3 weeks at number 2 during the summer of 1984 with this song. But under what comedy alias? I started to fall and suddenly woke in the dew on the grass. I soaked through my coat. All that I knew was a hole in my shoe, which was netting.
Wasn't he Neil in The Young Ones?
Yes, he was. It was that simple. Yes, well done. Your last question is worth 3 points. This will get you into double figures.
Oh, come on.
Name the rock band from Finland who reached the UK top 3 in 2004 with the song called In the Shadows.
The Rasmus.
Yes. Well done, you scored 12.
Fantastic, really happy with that. Played the joker too early, I think, but there you go.
Well, that's a tactic that a lot of people are using at the moment, but I think it's a good one personally, because if you'd have got it right, you'd have got 6 points.
Yeah, that was my thinking.
So well done. Let's see if that score of 12 is enough to win you the smart speaker, and we'll find out after this.
There's nothing like getting your head stuck into a good book and then telling a friend all about it. And here at the Radio 2 Book Club, we'll be doing just that in our new podcast. I'm Zoe Ball. Join me for Essential Book Chat as we delve into the best in new fiction, from literary superstars to the writers of the future. With reviews and interviews from top authors and from you, our lovely Radio 2 listeners, we're here to give you tips on the next gem you might want to add to your bulging bookcase. From hardbacks to paperbacks, we've got you covered. The Radio 2 Book Club with Zoe Ball. Listen on BBC Sounds.
Well then, there you go. That's something to listen to once you've finished with this. And don't forget, with BBC Sounds, you can subscribe and get your favourite podcast downloaded directly to your device so you can listen whenever and wherever you want. Anyway, let's crack on. 10 to the top.
BBC Radio 2. 10 to the top.
So 12 is the score to beat. Pretty decent bar. Let's see if Craig Rutherford in County Durham can beat that. Morning, Craig.
Morning.
How are you feeling?
Yeah, I'm feeling good. Feeling a bit nervous, but good.
Hey, don't be nervous, because you boys beat Sunderland. You're a big Newcastle fan. You beat Sunderland at the weekend. You must have been nervous for that one. Huge derby.
I think you used the wrong word, beat. Beat them up, thrash them, was the words you're looking for, Vernon.
Oh, it's an open wound and you just sprinkled a lot of salt in there. It is a great derby.
Yeah, we had a great day. Went with my son. Fantastic atmosphere as always. And yeah, really good. Good day out.
Fantastic.
Mind a big up to Ben, mind supporting Telford. I thought I had it bad over in Newcastle, but...
Hey, hang on a minute. That makes three of us. You want to try being a Bolton Wanderers fan?
Well, I've been to Bolton a few times, Vernon. Had some nice days out there. That's all right. Yeah. Friendly people. Good beer.
I like that. Bolton. Good beer. Yeah. That's what it should say on the motorway.
On the sign
as you enter.
When it goes in. Yeah.
Bolton. Welcome to Bolton. Good beer. you once swam with crocodiles in Australia.
No, I didn't realise at the time. I was in Australia with my nephew for the 2010 Ashes series.
Oof.
And it was a day off for cricket, and we were just wandering about outside Adelaide, and we come across this river with people in the river swimming. So I thought, oh, well, you will jump in here. It's red hot, nice day. And then when we got out, we were advised that there had been crocodiles spotted in the area.
Ooh.
Recently. There hadn't been any attacks, right. Running, luckily. And I certainly wouldn't have gone in if they told me that before I went in.
How do you usually do on 10 to the top, Craig?
I don't normally keep an actual count of how many I get, Vernon. I just, like, I'm usually out walking my dogs, to be honest, and I just keep a check on how many questions I get right. Sometimes I get three right, sometimes I get one. I'd be happy with double figures,
yeah.
as everybody usually says.
Yeah, good stuff. If you get double figures, well, you've got to beat 12 to get the smart speaker, but if you don't, you get a new coffee mug if you don't beat Ben's 12, which is, you know...
That's fine.
It's good either way, exactly. So I'm just going to remind you again, all the answers or all the questions are related to decades ending in 4 from the 60s onwards. So are you ready?
I am, Vernon.
All right, here we go. Your first point. In what year did ABBA win the Eurovision Song Contest?
1984.
Craig!
74.
Yes! Oh, Craig! I think they were a bit too disco glam for the 80s, weren't they? They didn't. The shoulder pads weren't
probably
that big. You know, I think
I was just thinking back in the 80s, you know how it was in the 80s.
Well, I don't actually, because I'm too young, no. Craig.
you're not allowed to say that, Vernon.
No. Anyway, let's move swiftly on. For a point, here we go, Craig. Come on, pal. Confidence is a preference for the habitual voyeur. Are the opening spoken words of which 1994 Britpop song?
Oh, it's Blur, isn't it? No, sorry, it's not coming, Vernon.
Park Life!
It's just hard to drag them out sometimes, isn't it, from the midst of time?
Yeah, remember, it's those iconic words from Phil Daniels, the actor.
Yes, I recognise the words exactly, yeah.
Yeah, all right, for a point, let's get cracking. Come on, you still got your joker to play, so we can still do this. From 2004, here's the debut hit for an American group who've had a total of 22 top 40 entries in the UK. Who are they?
Be a guess. Easy Beats.
Oh, unlucky. The answer was Maroon 5. Right, come on, pal. We've got no points. We need to get at least one. Then we can possibly play our joker and double it up. Right, here we go.
Yeah.
Complete the title of this top 10 single from 1984. So take yourself back to that. It's by Fiction Factory. Feels like what?
The Real Thing.
It was Feels Like Heaven.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
So I'm coming back now.
Yeah. It's easier when you know the answer, isn't it?
Exactly, yes.
All right.
Never mind. Let's crack on.
We are cracking on. Hey, we've still got five questions left, so you're all right. This one's worth a point. In 1994, which legendary US soul singer had her biggest UK hit of the 90s with the song A Deeper Love?
Soul singing's not my thing. I'll go Aretha Franklin.
It is Aretha Franklin. We have 1 point.
Back of the net.
Yes, get in there. For 2 points, which great British band had their first two hits in 1964 with the songs You Really Got Me and All Day and All of the Night?
That's the Magnificent Kinks.
This one's worth 3. Which member of the Black Eyed Peas had a number one single in July 2014 called It's My Birthday?
I'm going to have to pass on that one, Vernon, sorry.
Oh, no, it's will.i.am.
Oh, I didn't even know he'd... I do know that name.
Right.
I didn't know he'd been in the Black Eyed Peas, Vernon.
Right, OK.
Sorry, yeah.
Here's a question for a point. Give me the title of the 1994 top 10 hit that saw Salt and Pepper collaborate with En Vogue.
Push It.
No, it was What a Man.
All right. They did do Push It, I think, though, didn't
Salt and Pepper did, yeah, on their own. That was one of their biggest hits. This one's worth a point. I'm going to play you a top 5 single from 1984. Which featured on the soundtrack to the street dance film called Breakin'. Remember it very well. Can you name the duo who brought us this tune?
No, it's probably wrong, but I'll have a guess. Which will be completely wrong. Erasure.
No, it's not Erasure. It's Ollie and Jerry.
All right.
Yeah.
I haven't heard of them, to be honest. Apologies to that.
No. I remember walking around Horwich Town near Bolton with my lino and my beatbox breakdancing to that big tune. Right. It's your last question. It's worth a point, but because we've not played your joker, we're going to do it now. It's now worth 2. Name the group whose 1984 chart entries include Doctor Doctor and You Take Me Up.
Was it the Thompson Twins?
Yes, it was the Thompson Twins. Well done, Craig, you got 5 points.
Excellent. Half of what I wanted, but it's been a pleasure and one of my ambitions.
Oh.
To speak to you, not just to be on the quiz, obviously. I bet you're buzzing to talk to me as well, actually. So.
Do you know what, Craig? You've put not just myself, but the nation in a right proper good mood now. So thank you for that. Craig, it's been a pleasure. We're going to send you the BBC Radio 2 10 to the Top coffee mug in the post. And thank you very much for playing. But congratulations to you, Ben.
Thank you, Ben. Yeah, no, he had some tough questions there, Craig, to be honest. I got the first few, but after that, I was struggling.
Yeah, it was a tricky session, that. But well done, Ben. You've won the smart speaker. And thank you again, Craig. You've won the coffee mug. And if you want to play, all you got to do is get in touch. Use the email address. It's 10 to the top, all letters, no numbers, 10tothetop@bbc.co.uk. And if you've got the WhatsApp application, 08000 288 291, send us your details on that and a member of the team will get in touch. We'll play again tomorrow. Of course we will, 10:30.
10 to the top on Radio 2.
BBC Sounds. Music, radio, podcasts.
Tired of ads interrupting your favorite show? Good news. Ad-free listening on Amazon Music is included with your Prime membership. Download the Amazon Music app or visit amazon.com/adfreesports. That's amazon.com/adfreesports to catch up on the latest episodes without the ads. Enjoy thousands of Acast shows ad-free for Prime members. Some shows may have ads.